So, hello and welcome to our talk about TOX. My name is Nick Soroka and this is Sudden Six. We're both colleagues and working on TOX for about 3 years now, at least. So TOX is a secure and open source P2P communication method. For those who haven't heard about TOX, TOX has been around since, I think, 2013 in the wake of the whole Snowden leaks. And it's intended to be a replacement for Skype. So it has the basic features that every instant messaging service should have, like instant messaging, audio, video chat, group chats. But instead of Skype, it's decentralized. What this means is that if somebody shuts down your server or you can't access this specific IP address anymore, then you get locked out in Skype, but you won't get locked out in TOX. So this is really easy. TOX is not only a protocol, but TOX is also a complete ecosystem of a protocol, a library, which is currently written in C, the reference implementation, and there is a multitude of clients right now. The focus of TOX is actually not about privacy, about anonymity, but only about privacy. So we are sending messages completely encrypted, but it's not anonymous. So people will see that you're sending messages from one peer to another peer, but they won't see the message content. So why is TOX great? So TOX is open source, and if you have been to the keynote, you should know the benefits of open source. You can just inspect the code and improve it yourself if you want. It's completely distributed and peer-to-peer. As soon as you're connected to TOX, your own client actually acts as a TOX node. And everybody else could also connect to your TOX node as well. So you can actually set up your own TOX network, but yeah, can also use the existing one right now. It's completely encrypted. On Skype, you never actually know which message is encrypted and which isn't. And then on other services, you might not know as well. But on TOX, everything is sent completely encrypted. It works out of the box. What this means is you just have to install TOX. And as soon as you've installed it, you will get a public TOX ID. And you can just start sending messages to your friends, invite them to group chats, and make video calls, for instance. There is, as I said, there is a multitude of clients also. So, for instance, the most feature-rich right now is Qtox, which is in Qt and written in C++. It's supported on multiple platforms like Linux, Windows, Mac, BSD. I think there was also an effort to put it on Android. but for Android, it's actually better to use a native Android client, which is Trifa right now. This is the most stable one. If you're a fan of GNOME, for instance, you can also use my client, which is Venom. It's pretty lightweight, and it's Linux only, but it doesn't have to be Linux only. Right now, it's Linux only. And then there is also, for those guys that like ultra-lightweight clients, you can use Utox, which is pretty much doesn't have any dependencies, I think, pretty much. Yep. So I'm going to hand over to Sutton.
Okay, so hello. I'm Sutton Six. I am one of the lead developers of Qtox. And if you start up Qtox, this is how it will look. So if you added a few friends and start to chat, you will see this picture. And now I'll go to explain a bit what we see here. So on the left side, you can see your friends and groups like in any other chat client. On the right-hand side, you have a classic chat view. TOX supports file transfers, audio calls. So we have all the UI elements here, and you can also use emoji. For the more general features of Qtox, what you get with it is full audio and video support on all platforms. So this is not something you get from all chat clients under Linux. The message database is encrypted if you want it. You get the full support for Tox group calls, even with audio support. What I very much like about Qtox is it's multi-window mode, so if you chat with multiple persons in parallel, you open multiple windows, each for a friend, and you can just view all the conversations at once. We try to make the client highly configurable, but at the same time, we want to keep sane default settings, so you just start it up and you start chatting. And last but not least, Qtox aims to be pretty stable, so we don't release the client if we know there are major bugs in the master branch. So the last release is quite old, but we know nearly all of its bugs, and it's quite usable at the moment. Yeah, now a bit about the future of Tox. In general, for the next big feature, we want to implement a new group chat protocol that is similar to of the feature set to what IRC provides. So you get different privileges. So at the moment in the Tox group chat, everybody has the same rights. There's no kicking, no ban, no mute of anyone. We want to add this so it becomes usable for bigger groups than some guys from Russia and Korea implement Rust, the Tox protocol in Rust. If anybody of you is a Rust fan, this is the way to go. Of course, everybody needs a dark team nowadays. So you have seen it in the screenshots. Qtox has a dark team already, but this is the master branch. We have to release it. We want to implement some bots for friend finding, because this is one of the main challenges with Tox. You have to exchange these Tox IDs, which we will see afterwards, the process. And finding friends by name is not that easy if you're not just sitting right next to them or have another means of exchanging this ID. And we have continuous projects that do propose build clients. So one of the developers thought, hey, let's take this Tox phone application and build it into a phone. And this is what you get. So you have the really well-known usable user interface of a phone, but all the calls go over the internet, are completely encrypted, and of course, if you have internet access, you don't have to pay anything for the call. And this has even a webcam, so you can do video calls with a normal phone. Yeah, so if you're interested right now, these are some important links if you want to download it. Our main page, tox.chat, it lists frequently asked questions, links to the wiki to all the clients, and has a download page with binaries for all clients. Trifa, if you have an Android phone, you can just search for Trifa on the Google Play Store or on F-Trade and start trying it out right now. Qtox has its releases hosted on GitHub releases. So, and also we publish every stable release onto FlatHub. And Venom is also published on GitHub releases. Yeah, and this was all pretty much abstract, and now we are going to show you a short video of a typical Tox user interaction. So what will happen here is we have two clients, Alice and Bob, and Bob will copy its Tox ID and give it to Alice. So this sends then a friend request, and after they two become friends, they can chat with each other. So now they, Bob accepts the friend request, and they connect after some time, both are online, and they can start chatting. So, and we also put a small group chat demo here. So now we have a third client called Caesar, and they will begin making a group chat. So groups also, you have to be invited. Everybody has to be invited to a group. So this is the actual group chat. And yeah, the third client was hosted on a different laptop. But now we have a group chat with three people, Alice, Caesar, and Bob, and yeah, they can chat. So you all can see it's very usable at the moment for your typical instant messaging needs. Yeah, that's about the most content. Now, does anybody of you have any questions?
How are the IDs of the users generated?
These IDs are for the most part a public key and a small value for to prevent spam and checksum, so it's a public key of a public-private key pair.
Okay, thank you.
What if I want to use this on different devices? How do I exchange the keys and stuff like
that? One of the most common methods to do this. One of the most common methods to do this is mostly with QR codes, for instance. This makes it a bit easier to exchange the IDs. But otherwise, yeah, you have to get it to some to the third party at some point.
And about the video chat feature, how much bandwidth does this use and can I configure this?
In Qtux, you can only select the resolution, and about the bandwidth, it's a VP9 encoded video stream. So I think it's targeted around 2 Mbit for 720p resolution, I think.
So if bandwidth is one of your concerns, then there is also a problem that as your client is also acting as a node, it will send data even if you're not transmitting messages, for instance, because it needs it to discover friends and so on. Mm-hmm. In the network. So if you're limited to some bandwidth, then be aware of that. Yeah.
Okay. The big issue with instant messengers these days is you have to get other people into the messenger, right? So and there's a multitude of them. Let's say I'm a Telegram user, right? And I actually got other people to use Telegram, not WhatsApp. Or a colleague of mine uses Matrix. Are there things that Tox does sort of better or different than Telegram?
One of the main benefits of Tox is it's very easy to use. To just set up, you start the client, exchange the ID, and it's very reliable. On Telegram, I think your servers can go down or yeah, whatever, and in Tox, this cannot happen. There are no servers. You can also use it in a sort of an island configuration where you don't have internet access for talks. This is not possible with Telegram, as far as I know.
Hi, thanks. How does If it's a completely sort of peer-to-peer system, how is the initial connection established? Do you have to sort of route through some central server, or?
You have some pre-configured nodes. You have some pre-configured nodes, and that's how this works. But you could also set up different nodes or create your own network, for instance. It also works on local area network, for instance, with local area.
Local peer discovery, so yep. Just per broadcast.
Okay. So I'm a current Riot user, so Riot and Matrix. What if I set up my own Matrix server and use Riot? What are the advantages and disadvantages compared to using Tulx?
Are you familiar with Riot?
I'm not really a Matrix user, so I can't really say.
The benefit with Tulx is you don't have to set up the server. It's just, I think it's easier to use for use cases, for example, online gaming, where you have a powerful PC and instant connection. There it can play out its strengths with reliability and audio quality. But yeah, for mobile, it's difficult.
Thanks. Is Tulx on protocol level? Is Tulx distinguishing between transport layer and application layer, or is this kind of a mixed protocol where you basically can only do such use cases with that? Or do you have a more generic layer where you can say, I can also implement some other applications, some other use cases with the need of a decentralized P2P network on base of that?
Yes, Tulx supports such use cases. You have the ability to send custom packets or to implement custom packets. It was used, for example, for a VPN client. So you have two Tulx nodes running, and they build a VPN between each other. Remote shell, what else?
Okay. Yeah. So on protocol level, it's UDP. So you're sending UDP messages, and they are, so Tulx keeps.
But you need some kind of lookup method where participants of, for example, a group are finding together if you don't have some directory services or such a thing.
This is all handled via this Tulx ID. So you have to add each peer explicitly via the Tulx ID. And you can only invite friends, people to groups who you are friends with. So you have to first do this ID exchange.
You can, however, be in groups with people you are not friends with.
Yeah, but you have to be friends with at least one of the group members. So this is how.
Yeah. So a friend of a friend can communicate with me. Yeah. This level is generic, so it is not bound to the use case of chatting, of exchanging messages, but you could exchange data, or, as you said, VPN. Okay, how is the API to this? Do you have a C++ API for, well, you said you have a C++ client, so Qtulx. So I assume, yes. Is there some overview?
The library is itself called Ctulx Core, and it's a C API. So it should work everywhere. We have, here's the repository for Qtulx, and I think we also have the link for the core library. So it's a core library, and on top of that, we built the clients. But the core library is written in a way so that you can use and abuse it for different stuff.
Okay, I see here Ctulx Core.
Yep.
Ah, okay. Documentation is proper, so that's, I don't need to look into the code to see.
The documentation is in the header file in the Doxygen format, I think.
Ah, okay.
So
perfect.
The API is quite well documented.
Okay, perfect. Thanks.
One more question regarding video. Does any of the clients support desktop sharing?
So. Yes, Qtux supports desktop sharing.
Also Utux.
Utux too, I've heard. Yeah. Yep. So you can do that. But for Qtux, currently only under Xorg and not under Wayland, because that's not possible with Wayland, as far as I understood, or very different to implement.
Hi. What about messages to offline clients? For example, in group chats, that could be that one client is offline, but the others are online. How is this handled?
Messages are only possible if clients are online. So if you're offline, you don't get the message. In Qtux and most other clients, direct friend messages are cached until the other peer is online again. So it's just delayed.
Can I use the same identity on multiple devices at a time?
No. The current workaround for that is to create two identities, because then yeah, you just name them differently.
Okay. And another question, the crypto stuff in the protocol, did someone in your group handle this themselves, or is this an external dependency? So who knows enough about crypto to implement it?
The crypto is based on, I think, Libsodium, but the protocol itself is self-made. No further questions? Then thank you.
Thank you.